As crop losses mount, mission to Mars, NASA's sophisticated Curiosity rover on a quest for signs of life on the red planet.
Good morning, everybody. Good to be with you. I'm Terrell Brown. High heat and dry conditions this summer are fueling a drought of epic proportions across the United States.
Sanjay Gupta remains with us. We're joined in New York by Dr. Mehmet Oz, health expert for the Oprah Winfrey Show.
And how it's already affecting the U.S. economy.
Well, swine flu occurs when a virus that lives normally on pigs somehow mutates and changes and becomes available to the humans that take care of those pigs. So we believe that sometime in very early April, maybe end of March, in a small town in Mexico, some of these viruses, which again very commonly live on pigs, jumped into humans and they mutated in a way that scares us.
Police he killed a housemate and then ate part of the victim's heart and brain. WJZ is live in Edgewood right now. Mike Kelgo with even more stunning details on this crime. Mike?
Declined to speak about the chilling crime. Police say Kinyua's brother found the remains and his father called police.
Because now that we've been able to look at this virus carefully, it seems to have an ability to drill into human cells that's different than other viruses that we have examined in the past. And once, of course, these viruses get into human cells, they replicate themselves, they trick our bodies into allowing them to replicate, and they explode and cause the clinical syndrome that we see.
Is it a virus?
We don't know.
How does it spread? Is it airborne?
It's a possibility. We don't know.
Is this an international health hazard or a military concern?
Both.
Are these people alive or dead?
Hold them down!
And it kind of is always quite a strong kind of
presence. How long you'd been in the area and whether you had noticed any escalation of police action or gun crime?
My name is Joseph Quinn. I don't know how I've gotten this far, but I did. I don't know if there's anyone else alive out there or it's just us. I don't belong here, in this world, where the dead walk the earth and feast on the living. I have a brother out there, I haven't seen him for 2 days now. We've been on a supply run and our group's counting on us to make it back. So I got out of the city fast and I've survived. And I've realized that I'll do anything to keep it that way.